You're with us here on a fresh new edition of Trading Hour. The market is down about 30 points on the Nifty. The Nifty Bank is down about 45 points, and it's not looking like a very bad or poor session or so compared to what it looked like early on, because the market did take off. I mean, initially, it is, of course, a bit of a disappointment, but things could change. Remember, the market did bounce yesterday, but that was nothing. I mean, if you are talking about a bounce coming after the kind of selling that we've seen over the last fortnight or so, then, I mean, yesterday can only just be the start. And if the market fails to rally for another day, which is today, I mean, then I guess, bears have the advantage once again, and they'll press home that advantage to some degree. So important in that sense that stay ahead, and we manage a higher close, a decent, respectable higher close as far as the broader, bigger indices are concerned. So for now, we are, I would say, flat trading, 30 points, 10,318 or so is where the Nifty is at. Ekta morning.
Hi, Prashant. Can't take away from the mid-cap underperformance, though. So the mid-cap index is down another 0.5%. Weak advance decline ratio. And we have the rupee, which is depreciated back to levels of above 74. It was the closing of above 74 in yesterday's trading session, which was the first time ever. But nonetheless, after starting strong with an appreciation bias, it seems as though that depreciation is coming through now. But stock-specific action continues, and top of mind has to be with Tata Motors and what's happening with that stock. Remember, that stock is now the second top loser on the Nifty on a year-to-date basis. It's lost almost 60% of its market cap this year. And separately, currently it's trading at a six-year low, down 13-odd%. So we'll be discussing that stock. Yes Bank, which is managing to be quite resilient. A couple of these IL&FS group stocks declining in today's trade as well. And a couple of the sugar stocks which are managing to gain. So Balrampur Chini, for example, would be case in point. That stock is up around 7-odd%. But let's get talking about the technicals of the market. We have Sudarshan Sukhani joining in. Sudarshan, hi, morning. Your trade on the Nifty, and what would you tell your clients on Tata Motors?
Good morning. I have been telling my clients on Tata Motors for many months, please do not touch it. When it was 500, I thought it will go down. At some point, I was suggesting it will reach 200. Even I am surprised that it's broken down 200, but that's the way the trend goes. There's nothing in Tata Motors that even now we could see lower levels. That's for the stock. The Nifty, I'm much more upbeat on the Nifty. See, the first critical point that is required for a market to do anything is for volatility to subside. And that's happening today. For 4 days, 5 days, we have been having 100-point moves in the Nifty in just 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Luckily, that has come to a standstill. And that's the first requirement for any trending move in the market, up or down. So I'm much more upbeat on the Nifty. There is an intraday trade on the Nifty today as we speak. Buy the index, keep a 50-point stop loss, and exit at whatever comfort level you get. That's the indices for you. Stocks, of course, keep on offering opportunities all the time, even in volatile markets, less volatile markets. I would suggest buying in HDFC Bank. It's at the lows of the day, but that's the reason why we want to buy it. Have a stop loss which comes on your screen and take a trade on the long side. Also for buying is Titan. Titan has had an excellent chart. It did not correct when the broad market was correcting. Essentially, a very minor correction took place. It's doing well today and can continue with gains. The third stock is for a short sell, that is Hindalco. Yesterday's price action is bearish. I would expect lower levels to come. So all in all, I'm not so downbeat. I'm a little cheerful because volatility is coming down.
Okay, it's coming down so far, so good. I mean, yesterday, for that matter, was pretty volatile. I mean, if you actually added all the 50-point moves on the Nifty, all of the ups and downs, I mean, I think you'd get to a pretty big three-digit number there in terms of the moves that we saw and wild swings. So far, it's been much calmer, especially in the light of what went down yesterday. Tata Motors is, of course, on everyone's minds. Look at where that is. It's at 183 rupees. It's basically back to where it was in the January of 2012. So it's 6 years now, 6.5 years. We've got, of course, JLR data, which is come in. But let's get a view. Ashwin Patil, research analyst at LKP Securities, is with us to run us through what he's making of this fall and whether this looks overdone or this is fine. Ashwin, morning. What's your sense?
See, we know that the company is facing a lot of headwinds in several geographies. Now, the numbers which are trickling down from various geographies like Europe, China, US, etc., are not really very heartening. We know that in China, the company is facing trade wars and import duty hike, etc. And in Europe, there are Brexit woes still there, and control the pollution norms which are trying to control the usage of diesel vehicles, which JLR is about 45% of their volumes, are coming from diesel. So all these factors are actually impacting the overall sales. And to add to it, the company has announced a shutdown at their Solihull plant for about 2 weeks from October 22nd, and at their Castle Bromwich for three days per week. So also on top of that, they'll be paying the employees. So margins are expected to get hit in this quarter, in the third quarter. And as it is, we have seen dismal margins coming in Q1. Now we think that there will be some sort of slight recovery in Q2, but again, Q3 numbers will be dismally low. So considering all these factors, we think that the investors have given rightly the beating to the stock. And from these levels, I think it will take some time, more time to come back to levels which we can say are of some respect. And therefore, I think that...
Ashwin, what is your target price on Tata Motors, and what's your call on the stock as well?
My target price before the carnage happened was close to about 380, but now I need to revisit my stock considering all these factors which have come up after that.
Okay. As of last quarter, Ashwin, Tata Motors had provided a guidance of around, I think, 4 to 7% on the EBIT, if I'm not mistaken. 4 to 7% was their guidance. Do you think that they're going to stick to that?
It's difficult to say at this point in time, but there may be some sort of cut on that considering these factors which have emerged after that. It's been about 2 months since their call had happened, and now when they come up with Q2 results, that would be a key monitorable from our side.
What is your sense in terms of what they could report this quarter, specifically for JLR? Because last quarter was quite disappointing. They had, I think, margins come in lower by around 170 basis points year on year at 6.2%. And that's been the key concern with regards to JLR, the margins. So what's your expectation this quarter, given everything that we've seen?
There were some one-offs in the quarter, last quarter, that we had seen, and removing them, excluding them, the margins were still close to about 10 to 11%.
Okay.
Considering them, they were, the reported margins were close to 6.5%. So I think that there will be some sort of recovery, considering those one-offs will be going off this quarter, and the volumes have not been really very heartening in this quarter as well. But I think their hedge book, unwind, which had started happening over the past few quarters, I think there will be some sort of respite coming from there. But still there will be nothing great to take home from their numbers in this quarter as well.
So are you expecting a weaker quarter than what they reported in Q1?
Not really very weaker, but slightly better than what they had reported in Q1.
Okay. All right, Ashwin, yeah. We're going to let you go on that note. Thanks very much for joining in and talking to us. So that's the view coming in from LKP Securities with regards to Tata Motors. That stock down 13-odd% at this point in time. We'll do one thing. We'll take a break. But up next, we will focus on the mutual fund data, which was released for the month of September. Lakshmi Iyer of Kotak Mahindra AMC will join in with her view.